The question was, is it possible for a country to take a different road, a different path? The answer is yes, but you have to take measures to protect this experience from the finance, from the international finance. It means to think of the tools they can use to make your experience be a failure. So the first one is the financing of a deficit, of a public deficit. Today, you have to go, as I say, on the financial markets. And if you do, and this is a deep argument against the situation, because it's totally anti-democratic. A country, if it obeys the financial markets, cannot do any policy, cannot choose. It has lost its sovereignty. It can choose a policy which is against the interest of financial markets, because the financial markets have as a weapon, a terrible weapon, is to raise the rate of interest for financing the deficit public. So the first thing is to break this weapon and to finance the deficit, the public deficit, outside of the financial markets, which is forbidden by the European rules, but which is the necessary tool to help this experience not be a total failure. The second one is the debt, the stock of a debt we have to pay for. And that's the idea of a partial cancellation of an illegitimate debt. And the two things that is important to understand. First, it is a rupture not only with the international law or European rules, but it's also a rupture with class interest or finance interest. It needs a radical change in the distribution of wealth, and it goes against social interest, but the 1% that we see here. And the second idea is that we have to find a legitimacy for this kind of policy, and it can be found in there are two dimensions. One is the people, the interest of a majority of the people in this country, and the second one, which is very important, is to say we are not making our policies not against the other countries or against general rule, European rule, but it's in the name of another functioning of Europe, which we think is a best way for the European people. This is because in the European left, there are versions of this kind of strategy which are a little too nationalistic, saying that we are going to take our sovereignty, but implicitly it is to make policies which are against, which are non-cooperative, for example, devaluation of a currency and so on. So the European dimension is very important to build this experience. But the last condition is the political will that, for instance, Zapatero in Spain could have said, like the Argentina in the 2000s, we can't pay the debt, so we have to negotiate, or we discuss, and we are going to not pay all the debt. It's impossible. It's too expensive for our country. Hollande could have built an alliance with periphery countries against the austerity program. He did not do it. So here there is a dependency to the finance in the social democratic parties, which is an obstacle to and which has very important consequences, because it the idea is that the social democratic parties legitimate the idea that there is no other way that the austerity programs in Europe, and this is a very severe problem, because if there is no other way, the European technocracy says what you have to say, and there is no room for democracy.